All right, let's get rocking. Let's do it. A little song you might have heard me play once before. Take it back. Hey, before we get going,
back. Well, Mark sorts that out. Any bass players in the house? All right, wow, good showing. How about guitar players?
Pretty even.
Usually we're outnumbered. drummers. All right, bass players like drummers. You're in good standing. How about singers today? We got some singers? All right. I guess technically we're all singers, right? We all carry the instrument with us, right?
Thank you. little warm-up number.
Going, man. Jeez, that's a, doesn't matter how much you warm up backstage, man. You come out and play that, I'll just kick your butt. So, does it sound okay out there? Can you hear
that? Yeah. Yeah.
Sounds horrible up here. Which leads me to anybody in bands out gigging out, playing? Okay, a lot of you guys. So, all right, so I'm dealing with what you deal with, which is what I deal with, which is, you know, you walk out on stage. You know, how many of us, we get in rehearsal, it all sounds good, right? We're rehearsing, we know what it sounds like, and then when it comes showtime, as much as to the audience it looks like this cool big rock star thing, when you're on stage, it's like, you're up, go now, right? A lot of that kind of stuff going on, right? And all of a sudden the monitors sound bad, and how come I can't hear the drummer? There's no vocals, right? Has that happened to anybody, right? So, well, that's kind of how real life is, isn't it, you know? So, you know, as a player, I started playing, I took some piano lessons as a kid. In fact, it wasn't even as cool as the piano. It was a Wurlitzer organ. That's how, right? That's how I started, from the Wurlitzer organ, right? So, from the Wurlitzer organ to Megadeth. Go figure, you know? And I didn't want to start there, but that was what we had in the house, was that instrument. So I took some lessons, and I learned how to read treble clef with the right hand, bass clef with the left hand, and then organ's got foot pedals, you know, some more bass clef. And then I took up tenor saxophone in fifth grade in school band and played that, didn't really care for it. Thought the sax looked kind of cool. I now know that apparently ladies really like the saxophone, so I should have gotten better at it, but it wasn't cool. So at 11, I picked up the bass. You know, I was really into my Kiss records and BTO and, you know, all the stuff that was popular when I was a kid. And there was just something about the bass that I liked, you know. So I got my Mel Bay books, volume 1 and 2, and I'd come home after school and I'd sit in the basement and I'd read it. And you know, but there were some great things that I was taught. You know, they showed like how to keep your, you know, the finger position on the neck. You know, I keep my hand in kind of like a C position. I don't do a whole lot of like the sort of clamping over. You know, I do, you know, kind of more of that. I feel like I can get up on the fingertips, play in between the fret wire, but closer to the actual fret. You know, for a really kind of big part of how I play is that real precision type of fingering and stuff. As a result, you know, I started to play with fingers, but then I moved to pick. I found, you know, playing in big, loud rock and roll bands as a kid, I didn't have big 810 amps like we have here today. I just had little 212s and... Guitar players are always too loud, right?
Oh, yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Always, right? Well, yeah, probably about 50 watts for a guitar player. We need like 300 as a bass player. I couldn't afford 300. You know, I can afford 100.
And they're always telling us to turn down.
I know. Yeah, well, you know, that's why we have bigger amps, like these Harkies, so we can kick your ass finally. You know? So, in fact, I got to tell you, you know, me and Fred, you know, we go around the world. We played all these arenas and stadiums this last year and Big Four and all this stuff, and we used two of these 810s. And one of these LH1000 heads, and we run the thing on 2 every night. And when we're really getting rowdy and pushing it, we go to 2.5. You know? So that's how cool these Harkies are.
Black
t-shirt, you know. Except for the guy with the red shirt asking the question. But you know, we're a tribe, right? We kind of listen to the same music. We tend to play the same. We have a lot of commonalities, you know what I mean? And this is why I think it's really cool that Frank and I are at a time when we can come out and do this. Because we have a style about how we play. Our bands have a similar style, of course, and we're, you know, from a similar genre. Just like how Stu Hamm and Victor and those guys have a kind of a similar style and genre. So, you know, in our world, most of our music is very guitar derivative, you know. And Frank and I have had in our bands a really unique opportunity to create as bass players within a very heavy guitar and drum dominated world that we live in, you know, and it's cool that both, you know, both of our bands have had that opportunity. I know in my case, you know, Dave Mustaine was always very much like, dude, let's have the bass play this, you know, why don't we have the bass do this part, and you know, the you know,
yeah,
you know what I mean? But one day he looked at me and says, why don't you play that, you know, bang, and there it was, you know, So I don't know what your experiences are like that.
For Got the Time, we'll go back to Got the Time again. Charlie comes up to me, we should, why don't we jam this song? We just jammed it, and I am not a soloist. I love what they do, the soloists and stuff. I tend to play by myself and stuff, but Charlie said, there's a bass solo, and I knew the song and stuff, and I said, no, there's not. You know, I tried to... it's really, because I just didn't want to take the lead. I'm a bass player, like give my little tasty parts and coming out, little banging right. It out, you know? But I found out it was fun. I found that, you know, doing the bass solo, whatever it is, it is. It came out of me, and we redesigned it, and Eddie Kramer and I, we just kept going for it. I found it to be fun, but I certainly don't want to be the lead guy. I want to give the little taste, and I think that's what we do. We have the little roadmaps, these heavy riffs, and we kind of, through bass, we have these little roadmaps we take. Oh, let's leave a little taste, add to the song there. Little taste. You do some great stuff at, just the last song, Peace Sells, man. There's some great stuff that I don't even think it's heard if you really listen deep. Like, we have the bass here. Right. Our ears immediately go to the bass player's out here. You go right to the bass. What is the bass player doing? And there's so many great things that you do in that. And I'm not kissing up. I love you. But I just think there's some underrated stuff in there that people just don't, the common metal guy doesn't hear.
Until we do a clinic, and then you can actually hear it.
And then, this is why we do the clinics.
Track, yeah, exactly. Like Britney Spears.
Go ahead.
That's what happens.
What's it like going from clubs to arenas, and what was it like with Clash of the Titans?
The original Clash of the Titans? Yeah. It was great. It was just a great vibe. I mean, obviously, this is like a big high school reunion thing for us. Yeah. It's like, even with this Big Four thing, we grew up together. Like, guys your age, like the guys you know, even older, we went on tour together with this movement that we had, this thrash thing that just blew up. It was a really powerful experience. And Alice in Chains, and we all know
who all of our fans did not like.
You know,
that's the truth. Allison, what? I mean, that's a chick's name. Who are these guys? You know, it's like,
and we know, they were great. We watched them. The band guys always watched them on the side. We knew how great they were. That's why they were on the tour. And it's like, this band, and Lane, God rest his soul, dude, he went and put it in their faces every night. And yeah, if somebody, like some idiot, would throw a can or something like that, he'd go right in the crowd. How many nights did that happen? it was incredible. And you knew that band was just going to, because they're that.
We're rock and roll.
Yeah. Rock and roll. And look, to do that tour, amazing. I love that tour.